this video, I'd like to work on one-step equations with both fractions and decimals. Now, in this first problem, we need to isolate the x, and since it is a division problem, we will isolate by multiplying, and so we can multiply 1.32 over 1, and what we multiply one side of the equation, we will on the other side, so we'll multiply 4 times 1.32. These cancel, and we're left with x is equal to 4 times 1.32. Now, if you remember, when you multiply decimals, I'm going to rewrite it so it makes a little bit more sense. So I'm going to write it to where you have 1.32 times 4. And I generally like to place the larger number on top. I just think it's easier to see it. And then we just multiply. At this point, I don't worry about the decimal. I just multiply, and then later I count how many numbers are to the right. So we have 4 times 2 is 8. 4 times 3 is 12. Carry the 1. 4 times 1 is 4. Plus 1 is 5. Now, we know that 528 can't be the answer. So if you'll notice, we have at 1.32, we have two numbers to the right of the decimal, 1, 2. So we need to place two numbers to the right of the decimal with the answer. So we go 1, 2. So it'll be 5.28. So in this instance, x is equal to 5.28. Okay? Next up, let's go ahead and look at the one in the middle. Now, it's a little more involved, but again, we have a division problem, so we'll use multiplication, 1.213. So these will cancel, and x is equal to 23.21 times 1.213. Then to multiply them, I'm going to put it in a little bit different form so that it's easier to see. And what is that? 1213. And then I start multiplying. Let's go 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. There's 9. And that's 7. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 2. And then we have 2, 4, 6, 4. And finally we have 1, 2, 3, 2. And let's go ahead and draw a line. Bring the 3 down. We have a 3. 6 plus 1 is 7. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And this next one will be 5. Then we have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 8, and 2. Okay, well, now what we do, just like we did in the first one, we will count how many numbers we have to the right. And if you'll notice, I'll put the decimal here, put the decimal there, and this one has 1, 2 numbers to the right of the decimal, and this has 1, 2, 3 to the right. So I need 5 numbers to the right of the decimal. So I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the answer is x is equal to 28.153. Okay, what I have done, since we have a fraction, is I've multiplied each side by 2.35s. That gives us x is equal to 1.4 times 2.35. I then am going to rewrite this to 235 times 1.4, and you can put the smaller number on top. I just think it's visually easier if you put the larger number on top. If you'll notice right now, I'm not worried about a decimal. I will do that at the end. 4 times 5 is 20. Carry the 2. That's 12. That's 14. Carry the 1. That is 9. And then we have 5, 3, 2. I then bring down the 0, a 9, 11, and a 3. And so that gives me 9, 10, 11. That's not a 1 there. That is a 2. Pardon me. So it should be 3, 2, 9, 0. Now I go back, and here are the decimal places. I have 1, 2 to the right here, 1 to the right there. So I now will have 1, 2, 3. So it's 3.290. So x is equal to 3.290. Hope that helps with solving one-step equations with decimals.